Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to be testing out a crazy mascara. When I first saw this on TV in the commercial, I was like, I have to give this a try, and that mascara is L'Oreal Unlimited Mascara. It's this one right here. This is the packaging and this is the actual product. Now, the reason I was captivated by this mascara is that it has a bendable wand. The wand handle actually bends, so you can apply your mascara either this way right here or like the regular good old-fashioned straight wand way. The bend allows you to apply mascara on easier and also have more precision. Sometimes it's hard to get your mascara in there because like your arms this way, your eyes over here, you're trying to like make weird facial expressions to get your eyes to pop so you can apply mascara on those lashes. I also like the fact that you can grip the wand pretty close to the actual brush here, and that gives you more control when applying mascara on your lashes. I don't know about you, but I've done this so many times where I accidentally get mascara on like the skin, and you know, if it's above the lashes, it's not a big deal, but if it's somewhere on like this area here, it's really hard to clean it up after, especially if it's like a good size chunk of mascara. So this just allows you to avoid all of that hassle. And as far as the actual brush, it's a plastic bristle brush with longer bristles at the base and then shorter bristles, almost like non-existent bristles at the top. And also the wand does bend like so. I think it just coats the lashes better because it like works with the movement of the lashes. So anyway, that is the deal with the packaging and the wand. As far as the claims of the formula, it's supposed to be lash lifting and lengthening. It comes in two colors, brown and black essentially. I think mine is actually like black is black or something, but that's basically the two colors it comes in as of right now. I am pleasantly surprised with this mascara. I thought this was going to be like a gimmicky thing. Honestly, I really love this mascara. So without further ado, let's just go ahead and jump right into the application. I hope you guys enjoy this video and let's get started. These are my lashes without any mascara on, and that's about to change. So let's see how good this mascara really is. Okay, I already like it so far. I will have to say that the bend does make it easier to apply mascara. Like, you don't have to bend your arm to get the mascara, especially like in the inner corner. The mascara is bent for you, so your arm can stay like at a more comfortable angle. I mean, I do feel like there's a little bit of like the gimmicky aspect to it because you don't really need this to bend, but it is easier. Like, it does make sense. It's definitely on like the more dramatic side, which I love. If it looks too natural, it's almost like, what's the point of applying it? But I do understand that some people do prefer a more natural look. If you do, this may not be for you. The lashes are separated, but I can definitely see fibrous bits in this mascara that are making my lashes thicker and more dramatic and bolder looking, which I'm loving. But again, it may not be for you if that's not your thing. It is supposed to be lengthening, but I'm actually kind of, I'm not really sure if I'm seeing too much lengthening going on right now, but let me just keep applying it and maybe I'll change my mind. I mean, I am starting to see some of those fibers, like you can see right up top here. They are starting to build one on top of the other, and that's creating some of the additional length. I thought I was gonna hate the brush, but I actually like it a lot. It does seem to be applying the mascara on pretty well. You can keep the mascara wand straight if you want to, like you don't have to bend it, although what's the point of getting this particular mascara if you don't need the bend? Even if I have the mascara wand straight, it's actually a lot less comfortable. My arm feels like it has to go in more. Not that it's a big deal per se, because like you're not gonna be doing this for a long time, so your arm can probably withstand that, but I'm gonna go ahead and bend it right back because I prefer it bent. I'm gonna have to see how it's going to hold up on my lashes. I don't know if it's going to start like crumbling down and create little bits of mascara all over my face. It doesn't seem to be too dry at the moment, but I have a feeling this is the kind of mascara that can get dry pretty quickly because it's kind of like fluffy, you know, that fibrous fluffy formula. This is it. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm going to go ahead and apply mascara on the other eye, but I'm gonna keep this straight. I'm just gonna tell you what I'm thinking as compared to having it bent. If I do it with a straight wand, I have to tilt my head back because my arm can't bend like this and go that way that easily. So I have to tilt my head back, and this is just so much more awkward. I also like how you can get right down to the base and have much more control over the wand. I'm kind of feeling like Twiggy right now. You know that 60s makeup look where you have like really dark separate lashes? I'm kind of getting that vibe from this mascara and I'm loving it because I don't have that many lashes on the lower lash line. I don't have that few, but I wouldn't say like I have a lot there either. And I really like that it's making what I have on the bottom look really nice and defined. Okay, I think it's been enough time and I can curl my lashes, so that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to take my lash curler and I'm going to do one eye first just to show you the difference between the two eyes. This is going to look really scary, but just bear with me. And if you're doing this, I don't know how familiar you are with a lash curler, but you have to be careful. I actually think some of the mascara came off a little bit because it was not done drying, but what I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to patch it up a little bit by applying a little more there. But this is the difference between the two eyes. This is the curled lashes after applying mascara, and this is the lashes with the mascara. But it's right underneath the lashes, so it's hard to see that anyway if you do make that mistake. I think I fixed my lashes for the most part, and this is what mascara looks like when you apply it, let it dry, and then curl it. All right, so this is the final finished look with the mascara on and my lashes curled, and honestly, I really, really love this mascara. I thought it was going to be kind of like a, it's okay, I don't know what to say about it, but I really do love this mascara. I'm going to insert a before photo without any mascara on, and then obviously this is me right now with the mascara, and I think there's a huge difference. I don't have any eyeliner on. I have a little bit of like a neutral eyeshadow. I did that on purpose. I didn't want to add any darkness on my eyes. I want the mascara to be like the sole focus of this video, so I think it did a great deal of difference, and I don't have the best, darkest, fluffiest lashes at all. I wouldn't say my lashes are terrible, but they're also definitely not anywhere like in the great range. What I'm trying to say is that this mascara can make a big difference if you don't have the most dramatic lashes, but you want them to look dramatic without applying false eyelashes. And actually, speaking of false eyelashes, honestly, like, if you apply enough of it, I think you can get away without wearing false eyelashes if you like that false eyelash look, depending on how big and bushy your false eyelashes are. Mine are usually pretty natural, and honestly, this mascara can totally replace them for me, which I love. First impressions, I will do an update maybe in the comment section or something like that once I wear this for a little while longer, but so far so good, so I'm happy with it, yay! Successful makeup purchase, woohoo! But yeah, I guess this is the end of my video. I hope you guys have enjoyed this. Thank you so much for all the sweet comments and the support I get from you guys. I really, really, really appreciate it. Hope you're having a wonderful day, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye!